It's Sybil Wilkes with what you need to know. Today is Friday, June 26, 2020. Number one, the nation's first black billionaire is telling the Black Lives Matter movement to seize the moment and form a separate political party. BET founder Bob Johnson says the time is now to show Democrats that they don't own black voters. The self-described lifelong Democrat has said he's undecided about who he will vote for in November. Number two, exactly 1 month after the murder of George Floyd by Minneapolis police, the U.S. House of Representatives voted on the George Floyd Justice in Policing Act. Thursday evening, House Democrats passed its effort to address racial inequities in policing. Senate Democrats voted down the Republican policing bill introduced by Senator Tim Scott Wednesday. Democrats say the bill is full of incentives to encourage police to do the right thing, like eliminating chokeholds. Republicans say the Democratic bill will undermine law enforcement agencies. Number three. As states have reopened and the virus has come roaring back in the majority of U.S. states, it's clear that we're at a very crucial time in the battle against the coronavirus. It's time we put the phrase, "we're all in this together," into practice again. Venture out only when necessary. Take this pandemic seriously. Wear your mask, wash your hands, and do your part. Please. Number four, following public outcry, including a petition with millions of signatures, Colorado Governor Jared Polis has ordered an investigation into the August 2019 death of Elijah McClain while in police custody. 3 days after the 23-year-old African-American artist, described as an angel among humans, was taken down by three white policemen in a chokehold, he was declared brain dead, and no charges were ever brought against the police. Number five. Mary W. Jackson, the first black woman engineer employed at NASA, is being honored by the agency for her role as a trailblazer in the field of science. NASA will name its DC headquarters after the scientist and trailblazer who was among a group of black women computers. That's right, human computers, whose knowledge contributed to the success of the U.S. space program in the 1950s. And that's what you need to know. For more information, please go to SybilWilkes.com and sign up for my free newsletter. Be informed, be empowered.